What's up everyone, Krona here today checking out some Conan Exiles. If you like the video, please remember to hit that like button. If you haven't already, please subscribe if you want to keep up with what I'm up to. And if you think others will enjoy the video, please remember to share it with them. Again, if you want to support the channel, please check out one of my support options in the video description. So this is the first time I'm playing Conan Exiles. I am just starting it. I've played a lot of Ark, played it with my wife and friends. We played on our own private server. So I decided I wanted to check this game out. There's a lot of people actually playing it right now, and I've watched a few videos. So I thought it was time for me to just jump in and try it out. So I know that there's a lot of different mechanics in this game versus Ark, and there's a lot of similarities. So I'm just going to get to it, and we'll start up and see how things go. Let's interact with this thing here and see what happens.
Behold, bonded one, the very boundaries of civilization. Beyond the passage of our highways, lie the wild places of the world, where untamed savages make endless war upon each other. You cannot pass into the endless wastes enslaved. Your bonding prevents it. Return. Follow the road. Any road. All roads lead to the city.
So I guess we're going to the city. Let's see what's over here. Looks like we've got a water skin and some note.
Left to rot among the ruins of the past. There are others here. Slaves. Bandits and cannibals. Exiles from lands I've never heard of. Some of them try to scrape a life from the wasteland, scrabbling in the rocks and sand for their own place. I cannot go on. The life that I left behind haunts me. The sun over the glittering spires of Belverus is forever denied me. The smell of my daughter's hair. I will pass the ghost fence. This cursed land will finally end me. To whoever reads this note, I leave the last of my water, and this message. Stranger, you have my pity. You do not know how cursed you truly are.
Well, that's pleasant. So we are cursed. Maybe not in the magical sense, but maybe. Yeah, I gained a level by picking stuff up. So this is probably, I assume, going to be like other survival games. We have to pick up a whole bunch of stuff and start crafting. So let's see what we've got in our inventory here. We've got the note. Got our water skin. Let's go ahead and pop that down here on number 8. Got some seeds, which I'm assuming we might be able to eat. I don't know. Bugs, which we could probably eat. And some crafting material. Can we make a pick yet? Nope. More branches. But we can make a tunic. And looks like we can make, can we make pants? No. We can make some gloves. So we need more plant fiber. So let's just pick up some of this stuff and cover up our exposed skin. Get a little bit of protection. So it looks like I've got a lot of gathering here. Dude, I keep dodging. I'm holding shift, and I guess shift, I don't know. I'm still learning the mechanics of it. You guys are going to see me die a lot, do a lot of stupid stuff. So just laugh it up and enjoy it with me, because that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'll probably die a lot here in the beginning trying to figure out the mechanics. I mean, like I said, I've played a lot of Ark, but, you know, one big difference here, at least to my knowledge, we cannot tame animals. If we can, I've not seen it done yet. But, you know, the other thing is I've tried not to watch too many videos. I like to come into the game and learn it and actually figure it out. That's how I learn things the best. I tried to do that with any game that I play. I do as little research as possible about the mechanics. I just do enough to see if I'm going to enjoy it. So we should have enough to craft some pants now. So yeah, there's our pants, and can we, still don't have enough for shoes. But we're going to have to find some food and water soon too, I assume. So, got to put a focus on that. And like I said, we played a lot of Ark on our own private server. We ran vanilla servers just in my basement for months. We started off on the center, my wife and I playing. We had a huge base. We had tons of dinos. We had a dedicated farm. And it was all vanilla. The only thing that we did was we upped the XP multiplier by about 25%. And we upped the taming speed to like 4%. Just to... It was all like quality of life stuff. Just to make the game more accommodating to play. I mean, sitting there for 8 hours trying to get a dino tamed was not something that we wanted to do. So, you know, we did a lot of that. Played it for months. We actually at one point had 3 servers working with cross-server transfer. And then we had a cataclysmic loss. Like the perfect storm of things that can go wrong. The game killed my backup, or the server manager had an update and killed the data for the server, and then my backup drive failed at the same time. Just like the perfect storm of stuff to get it wrong. So anyway, all that to say, we played a lot of Ark and we really enjoyed it. I don't know that I'll be playing this with my wife because she likes to play with the dinos. But as far as the survival aspects go, this looks pretty good, and I'm anxious to see how everything works out. I guess that's real enough about Ark. This is not an Ark video. This is a Conan Exiles video. So we've got... I like the crafting queue. That's nice. So we've got shoes queued up, pick, and a torch. Looks like we can level up. And I did this character... I don't know how much the race plays into it, but I always like to play with bows, so I am specking him to be good with bows, I guess. We'll see. I don't know how much of an impact that makes, but like I said, I guess we need to start finding our way to food and water. Got bugs at least, and a little bit of water in our water skin. Yeah, well, what is that? Pick up all these branches. I'm sure I'm going to need them. Do we have to fight that thing? I hope not. Nope. Buddy, you know, I'm a lot more scared of you. What's this?
Gods curse this sandstorm. We were forced to take refuge before the wind scoured the skin from our faces. There is something in the storm. Beasts. We hear the skittering of their paws outside the ruins, and their howls mingled with the screaming winds. The men are scared. I've put them to work crafting rudimentary weapons and torches from the loose stones and rough plants that dot this place. I've yet to meet a beast that liked fire, or the bite of the axe.
Ah, so basically just some tips to get you started. Craft crap out of stuff laying around and use a torch to fend off critters. Good to know. Alright, can we make anything else yet? Learn recipes. So we know that. I'm assuming because we've... Yeah, this is all green. Light turban. Can't make that yet because we have to be level 8. So this is Apprentice Craftsman. We have to be 3 for that. So I guess we learn Apprentice Craftsman. And that will give us the hatchet, the bedroll, and twine. Can we make a bedroll? No, we have to make some twine. How much twine do we need? 3. Can we make 3 twine? Yes. 1, 2, 3. What else do we need? Looks like we've got everything else for the bedroll. Now, hatchet. What do we need? We still need stone. So we've got a pick. Water. I've got a little bit of water. Awesome. So pick. That doesn't break. Do none of these stones break? Huh, what the heck? Okay, well. Oh, I like that. I can pick up stuff without having to put away my weapon. ARK players know what I'm talking about. Because in ARK you'd have to put away your current weapon before you can do a pickup. You know, this looks like the end of the road. I'm just gonna do what it said. Just keep going. Hopefully I'll find another road. Ah, what do we got here? Oh, you can hold E while you're walking and pick stuff up. That's awesome. I don't know how many of these branches we're going to need. Alright, so I guess we need to find a place to put down the bedroll. Oh, looks like there's some dudes down there. That may be bad. Can we do it right up here on top of this rock? Hopefully there's no baddies up there. Oh, this is shelter. Alright, so let's put the bedroll down right here. No. Oh man. Oh wait. There. E for more options. Interact. Cancel. Dismantle. Ah. So you just tap E and that becomes your spawn point. Awesome. So what else can we make? Do I have stuff for the hatchet yet? Nope. I still have to get some stone. I wonder if I can break these rocks. Ah, yes. Oh, that's awesome the way the rocks break apart. It looks realistic. That's cool. It's the little things, you know. Oh, we can have our torch out while we have another weapon. That's... And still pick stuff up. Do I have any more water? Yes, good. So I'm assuming I'm going to have to find some more water to refill this water skin soon. And I love the fact that you can hold E and just keep picking stuff up. That's great. I think they do that in ARK now, too. They may have always done it. I know for stone, though, I'd have to constantly tap E to pick stone up. At least at one point. Again, that may have changed. I've not picked up stone in ARK in so long, it's ridiculous. I always use creatures, so... Handful of insects. Yep, that's feeding me. Will seeds feed me? Nope. So insects will. Not a lot, but it will. Alright, can we make our hatchet yet? Yes. I wonder if that's going to give us enough XP to get to level 3. I guess I better put my torch down. E right there on number 3. Oh, that's awesome. You can see the fire burning from their location over there. So there's our hatchet. Oh, it looks like I did get to level 3. So let's go another... Let's see, survival. What a survival. Measure of your ability to live in harsh conditions. It affects how easily you metabolize food. Encumbrance is how much you carry. Grit determines the size of your stamina pool. Accuracy, which we need for a bow. I was getting ready to say vitality and I said bow. Vitality, health, agility is a measure of the ability to move when wearing different clothing types. It has a direct effect on armor. Ah, strength How much you do in melee? So let's put a point into survival. Sounds like we're going to need that. And let's learn some more recipes. So I can't craft a bow yet. That needs to be level 5. But in order to do that, what can we use? Yeah, we need survival. Because we need the campfire. So can we make the campfire yet? No. We need more branches. Yeah, more branches and more stone. So there's some more branches. Trying not to get too close to that camp over there because I've got a bad feeling about it. I'm living longer than what I expected already, so not going to push my luck yet. Now, see, that didn't sound good. Oh, there you are. You're ugly. Ugly. Taste axe. Corpse, loot, nothing on it. Ah, hide, bone, fear of flesh. Which, all of which I'm assuming we are going to need at some point. Let's get some wood. Ah, repaired my torch. Okay, looks like daylight's coming out, so put our torch away, try to conserve it a little bit. Get some more stone. Our water skin's empty. We're gonna have to find some water. Looks like water in that direction. Weird. Oh, that's sand or dust coming up off the ground. What's that? Aloe. Looks like aloe. That's combat music. Get off me! Ah, dead. Well, yeah, I'm starving. I'm dead and I'm starving. Chick, I'm dead. Stop. You killed me hard enough. Well, let's go see if we have a corpse. I'd really hate to lose that water skin because I didn't see a way to make one yet. Ah, dude, look, I just want my body. Leave me alone. Man, you two, what do you want from me? Well, there's two in a row. Said build a bed to save my respawn location. Are they just one shot? They are one shot. Oh man. They are one shot. Just like the bed rolls and arc. Alright. Well, I'm going to spend a little bit of time here and reestablish myself and try to get back to where we were. And make some progress, and then I'll be right back. Okay, so I've made some progress, but I have died like a ridiculous amount of times getting started. I've leveled up a little bit, put down some foundations, and have been managing to get my corpse and continue to level up. So I'm now just building a rudimentary little house to try to have a place to come back to safety whenever I encounter all this crap that's around here. There are some things around here that I just can't kill yet. And I'm trying to get to a source of water. So for the time being, I'm just, if I get thirsty, I just try to stay close to what's going to be my little impromptu base here, and I'll die of thirst and then just loot my corpse and try to keep going. So we're making progress. It's a little slow, but almost all of these games, you die a lot in the beginning anyway, so not a big deal. Just have to avoid pulling those guys close to the base if possible. And I've been looting all of my old stuff. Just dropping it. Because I had to keep remaking it to have a weapon to go get my corpses. And there were plenty of corpses. Believe me. I do like the way the structures are built, though, it's really nice. I wonder if I can dismantle this campfire. I don't know how dismantling works in this game compared to Ark, just as an example. Huh, loot bag. There's nothing in it. Did I get everything out of it? I don't know. Let's just try to build another one. And I don't have the resources, so. Man, they're getting too close. What do I need for the rest of my walls? More stone. Another wall? Yes. There we go. I do like the crafting system in it, though. It's pretty easy. You just go to learn the recipes, and you see the recipes here. It's a little confusing how the progression works in some regards, but actually, no, it's not, now that I'm looking at it, because if you learn one thing, then you can click on it, and it tells you everything that you can craft after you've learned that skill. So after I learned the experienced survivalist, I can do a campfire and a sealed water skin. The Acolyte of Mitra gives me these, and so on and so forth, so it's not that bad. I do need to learn to craft the sword, though. The sword I get at level 3, that means... Can I craft that yet? I learned stonemason. That and that. Mercenary level 4, so I have to be level 4 to learn mercenary, level 6 to learn archer. So I'm assuming then that I'm going to have to hit level 4 and learn mercenary so that I can at least have a stone sword and wooden shield. So we'll get to that point. In the meantime, I'm going to keep working on this base and have a safe haven, and I'll be back. Well, here we go. We have at least a basic little hut. Something semi-safe anyway. So it's a decent start. So far, I'm enjoying the game. Again, it's mainly survival, no dinos or anything, but that's okay. It's good to have a different experience. So I'm looking forward to seeing what the differences are in comparison. I mean, I've played a few of these survival games, but this one's a little different. So I'm enjoying it. Looking forward to seeing what's coming next. So I'm going to call it here for the time being and in the video. And I'll do some more offline work, try to make some more progress, and see where we can get. So if you enjoyed the video, please remember to hit the like button. If you want to keep up with what I'm up to, please subscribe. And if you think anyone else will enjoy it, share the video with them. And please check out my support options if you want to help see the channel grow and improve. And with that, I hope to see you guys in the next one.